We got a new match for you here today between the communist Cameron Patterson and Lydia Tarr Talcott. Who's going to win? Find out right now. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Real Trivia Face-Off. We're back here in the singles division, and joining me to host this awesome match between Cameron and Lydia, it is Matthew Chen. Matthew, sir, excited for today's match or not at all?
Yeah, no, I'm excited to. I'm excited for today's match.
Shocker.
Yeah, I know. Actually, I'm not excited at all. Cameron's in this match, you know, that's the only reason.
Yeah. No, we got a match between the communist Cameron Patterson and Lydia Tarr Talcott. What's your thoughts going into this one?
I mean, you know, Lydia is still searching for that first win, but we've also seen Cameron's, you know, path there as well. And so, you know, maybe it'll take time, but I know Lydia's hungry for that. They are very close in, you know, competitors. I think it's going to be a close game.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Lydia's still looking for the first win. She has unfortunate run into her current teammate, Maddie, and then obviously Matt. Matt was in a similar spot as Lydia, and now Matt got the first win. Similarly, Cameron, last year, 2 years ago, I don't remember when he got his first win. Later last year or 2 years ago, he was 0-6 at one point, but now he's 4-6. 4-6?
Yeah, I think
4-8.
Or so something. Okay.
He's got 4 wins since then. So, you know, we'll see if Lydia can, in terms of pacing, she can beat them in terms of that. But yeah, this should be an exciting match. Let's just go into the promos and see what they have to say, starting with Lydia Talcott.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's everyone's favorite 0% win rate player, Lydia. I'm here for a good time. Cameron is such a lovely person. He has given many threats, actually. If you could see the DMs on this match, there are a number of threats, like on my life, basically, made by Cameron, which I think is really not in the spirit of Real Trivia. So there's already something you guys should be looking out for. But like he said, he was 0-6 one time, and he even said maybe tonight's the time that I turn it around, I take home a win. And I have to agree with him. Tonight's the night that I take home a win against him. So I'm ready.
Bull fucking shit. Lydia, who is this fucking Lydia? I've never heard of her. In fact, I am still in hiding from how much pain and suffering I have caused to any trivia competitors. So all I'm saying is she should fucking watch out.
All right, Matthew, thoughts on those promos?
You know, I mean, it looks like Cameron has a few threats. So, you know, Lydia's hungry for that win, but we'll see if that comes back to bite her.
Yeah, we don't usually leak the threats that are happening in the green room, but if Lydia decides that it is her own best interest to leak them for her own safety, she's allowed to do that. And also, Cameron said that he's in hiding because he hurt people. I'm like, why is he in hiding if he's the one doing the hurting, not he's the one being hurt? I guess he's scared that he hurt people.
He's running away from, you know, the cops and all that.
Running away from the cops, gotcha. Gotcha. All right, fair enough. Okay, so let's just get into those intros and get this match started. So let's do that. Introducing first, with a record of 0 wins and 2 defeats, she is one half of 1.5 women. It is Lydia Tarr Talcott. And her opponent, with a record of 4 wins and 8 defeats with 2 technical knockouts, she is one half of the cage fighters. It is the communist, Cameron Patterson. So everyone is here. Cameron staring at his own reflection through the computer, monitor there. Both competitors are here. How are y'all feeling?
Well, now I'm like freaked out. He's pulling the freaky angle for this match, which the people are not receptive to, famously. So take that.
I think everyone's the crowd in the chat seems to be on Lydia's side here. Question mark. Should be an interesting match. Cameron doesn't give a shit, seems like, so we'll see.
Well, let's see if these threats will come true or not. And see if he can actually win with round one rules.
Yeah. So let's do that.
All right. In round one, both players get 8 questions from 8 random categories. You have 15 seconds to write down your answer, and they must be said out loud when you're revealing your response. Each question you get correct is worth 1 point, and if you get all 8 correct, you get a 1 point bonus question. Throughout this match, you get the use of 3 repeats and a challenge.
Any questions before we start?
Nope.
All right, so I will go ahead and read the first question here in the category of horror/thriller. Your question is, the Ain't Rights are the name of what kind of group in Green Room?
What color is your room?
It's like, well, there are different colors. We're talking about the wall, I'm guessing. It's like grayish, sort of very light gray, kind of. So, yeah. Answers in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, starting with Cameron.
No answer.
Okay. And Lydia?
I said Assassins.
Assassins, unfortunately incorrect. We're looking for a band, specifically a punk band. For a band.
Oh, that's tight, actually.
You know, like a green room for a band.
A green room for a band.
Yeah.
You know, that makes sense, actually. That's cool.
All right. So your second question is in the category of fantasy sci-fi. Rodents of unusual size, also called ROUSs, are creatures from what 80s fantasy film?
Now, I have been to a real physical green room before, but the walls are not green. So I was disappointed.
No. Yeah. Green rooms are generally don't have green walls.
I have seen green rooms with green walls, though, and they look disgusting. Yeah,
that's probably why. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll go to Lydia.
I said G-Force.
And we'll go to Cameron.
The Princess Bride.
The Princess Bride is the correct answer. So Cameron gets a point there.
Whatever.
All right, as we move on to the third question in the category of action/adventure. And your question is, who directed Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3? This film, good.
It is. Is it your favorite Guardians movie, or is it maybe second?
It might be maybe either first, second, I'm not sure. 5. I could already watch it. 2, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pants down. We go to Cameron.
James Gunn.
Okay, and Lydia?
I said James Gunn, but with 2 N's.
James Gunn is correct. Lydia did have the correct spelling, but you'll take both answers there.
Mm-hmm. Take that. Cameron's playing this really crazy, like, silent meta that is, like, freaking me out a little bit. Kind of psyching me out a little bit.
All right. Well, we'll see what happens with your next question in period/costume dramas. Who stars as adult Celie Harris in The Color Purple?
We got a green room question. We got color purple question. What is the next color do you think is going to pop up without looking into the document of the match?
Yeah, I don't know. It might pop up in round one, it might pop up in round two.
I'm gonna randomly throw out the color red.
Five. Four, like communism. Three, two, one. All right, we will go to Lydia.
I said Cynthia or Revo.
And Cameron?
No answer.
The correct answer was Whoopi Goldberg.
Okay, see, that makes sense.
Okay, so score stays 2-1 as we go to the fifth question in the category of holiday movies. Holiday movies. Martin Short plays what literary character in The Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause? Okay, so we all know that Santa Claus usually would have a red suit, right? But if you have to change the suit color into a different color, what would you pick?
I would I'd pick purple, like, you know, the color purple.
It seems royal. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pants down.
Santa might be royalty. You never know.
Fair. Go back to Cameron.
Jack Frost.
Okay, and Lydia? Jack Frost is correct. So one of them getting the point there.
Mm-hmm. Are we playing the Russian meta? Because we can do the Russian meta.
All right. Well, 3-2 going into your sixth question in dramas. Who stars as Jimmy the Gent Conway in Goodfellas?
What do you think of the nickname The Gent?
Gent?
No comment, I guess.
It's fine.
Is it better than the communist?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I don't think it's better than the communist. I think the communist is an incredible nickname. Lydia, let's start with you.
All I got was Robert. I kind of lost it on this one.
Cameron?
Joe Pesci.
Lydia was closest, but the answer is Robert De Niro.
Yes!
Fortunately, we need the last name as well.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
There's a lot of Roberts.
I sat there for so long being like, I know his first name's Robert.
Robert Scorsese.
Right? Right? That could have been it.
Okay, so let's move on to the penultimate question, category of comedies. And here's your question. In Night at the Museum, the item that brings all the exhibits to life is an artifact from what country?
What do you think is the best museum to go at night?
To go at night? You know what wouldn't be good? The Chicago Torture Museum at night. That sounds horrifying.
You don't want to get stuck in there?
No, hell no. I don't even want to be there in the day. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pants down. We start with Cameron.
Egypt.
Lydia?
Egypt.
Egypt is correct. So both of them getting the point there.
So 4-3, going into your final question in animated. What 2000s animated movie has a voice cast of Zach Braff, Joan Cusack, Steve Zahn, and Gary Marshall? I think a fan favorite Zach Braff.
I thought you were going to say fan favorite Steve Zahn.
I think this community has a lot of, you know, lots of Zach Braff fans.
Sure. I'll take your word for it.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll go to Lydia.
You already know that it's Chicken Little.
And Cameron.
Robots.
And with that, Lydia ties the game. 4-4. Yeah! The correct answer is Chicken Little.
Yeah. Tie game, solid round one. Nothing else to say. It is a solid round one. Couldn't ask for a better one because it's tight.
Yeah, exactly. You're very close.
Exactly. So, yeah, let's just go into round number two here. That's just the wheel round and how it's going to go. So that each competitor will spin the category wheel. If they like the category they land on, they can take it. If they don't like it, they can spin again, unless it lands on opponent's choice the first time around. Each competitor gets 5 questions from the category. Each question are worth 2 points apiece. They can go to multiple choice. However, it reduce the point value to 1, and their opponents is able to steal if the player provides an incorrect answer. So be careful with that. You still have all 3 repeats and the challenge, and we do need final answers. You submit your answer. Any questions?
No.
Okay, so here are the category for today's wheel. We have Tim Burton, romance, Denis Villeneuve, Audrey Hepburn, music musicals, 2010s, young adult adaptation, Disney animation, and spinners and opponent's choice. So since we're tied, we go to the high ranked competitor, which in this case is Cameron. So Cameron, would you like to spin first or defer?
Defer.
Okay, so this first spin will go to Lydia. Lydia, you ready for your first spin?
Swag money, sure I am.
Swag money, I've never heard that phrase before. Well, swag money works out, I guess.
Swag money!
Let's see, what's your pick?
I'll do music musicals.
Music musicals, okay. Matthew, you want to read that? Or
Albert, you can take this one.
You want me to take it? Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, Lydia, 5 questions, music musicals. Are you ready?
Okay.
Question 1. Justin Long, Matthew Gray Gubler, and Jesse McCartney co-starred as a music group trio in which 2007 musical?
Alvin and the Chipmunks, Final Answer.
That is correct for 2 points. Question 2. Who played Violet Mulligan, Mark Ruffalo's daughter, in Begin Again?
Multiple choice.
Okay. A. Haley Steinfeld. B. Caitlin Dever. C. Dove Cameron. D. Abigail Breslin.
B, final answer.
B is incorrect. Cameron, for the 1 point steal, your options again are A, Haley Steinfeld, B, Caitlin Dever, C, Dove Cameron, and D, Abigail Breslin.
D as in dog.
D as in dog is also incorrect. We're looking for A, Haley Steinfeld.
Oh my gosh.
No points earned by both competitors there.
Super didn't know she was in that movie.
Good film.
It is very good.
Question 3. Which 1962 musical was directed by Morton DaCosta and starred Robert Preston and Shirley Jones?
Multiple choice, please.
All right. Your multiple choice options are A, Bye Bye Birdie, B, Oliver, C, The Music Man, D, Fiddler on the Roof.
A, final answer.
A is incorrect. Cameron, for the steal.
The Music Man, final answer.
Holy shit.
that is correct for the 1 point steal. Lydia, your fourth question.
Woohoo.
What instrument does Chadwick Boseman's character Levy Green play in Marini's Black Bottom?
Piano, final answer.
That is incorrect. Cameron, for a 2 point steal opportunity.
Saxophone, final answer.
That is also incorrect. We're looking for a trumpet. A trumpet.
Ooh.
Okay. So going to the last question here, Lydia, in category of music musicals. What is the name of Keith's band in 2016's La La Land?
Oh, Matt's going to beat me up. Matt's going to punch me in the face. Give me multiple choice.
Okay. A, The Messengers. B, The Castaways. C, The Sailors. D, The Runaways.
B, final answer.
B is incorrect. Cameron for 1 point steal. Your options again are A, The Messengers. B, The Castaways. C, The Sailors. And D, The Runaways.
A, final answer.
A is correct for the 1 point steal.
Damn.
And at the end of that round, the score is now tied up 6-6. So, yeah. Cameron able to get some of those steals there.
Yeah.
As we go to the wheel for Cameron's spin. All right, Cameron.
Yeah.
Okay. Here it is. Your first spin. Well, lands on opponent's choice. So Lydia gets to decide again, but this time for her opponent.
Well, it's gotta be Audrey Hepburn, I'm afraid.
Okay, so Audrey Hepburn it is. So Matthew, you'll read the questions.
I will. Go ahead. Your first question in Audrey Hepburn. Which Audrey Hepburn movie centers on a two-day deadline where she needs to help William Holden's character write a 138-page screenplay?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Love in the Afternoon, B, Paris When It Sizzles, C, Sabrina, D, Charade?
A. Final answer.
A is incorrect for a 1 point steal. Is it A, Love in the Afternoon, B, Paris When It Sizzles, C, Sabrina, or D, Charade?
D, final answer.
That is also incorrect. We were looking for B, Paris When It Sizzles. Your next question. In Roman Holiday, what specific type of vehicle do Joe and Anne ride through Roman traffic that gets them arrested?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Vespa, B, Piaggio, C, horse carriage, D, taxi cab?
Vespa, final answer.
That is correct for 1 point. Your third question. In My Fair Lady, what did Eliza sell before meeting Professor Higgins?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, chocolate, B, fruits, C, tea, or D, flowers? Five.
Chocolates, final answer.
That is incorrect for a 1 point steal. Is it A, chocolate, B, fruits, C, tea, or D, flowers?
D, flowers, final answer.
That is correct for a 1 point steal. Your penultimate question. What famous character does Robert Shaw play in Robin and Marian?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Sheriff of Nottingham, B, Will Scarlet, C, Richard the Lionheart, or D, Robin Hood?
A, final answer.
That is correct for 1 point. And your final question. Who directed How to Steal a Million?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, John Huston, B, George Cukor, C, Billy Wilder, or D, William Wyler?
B, final answer.
B is incorrect. For a 1 point steal, there's an A, John Huston, B, George Cukor, C, Billy Wilder, or D, William Wyler?
A, final answer.
That is also incorrect. We were looking for D, William Wyler. So at the end of that round, I have Cameron at 8, Lydia with a 1 point steal there up to 7. So
yeah. Game. Very close, only 1 point differential there. Lydia getting the spinners and opponents. Lydia getting the spinners and getting opponents' choice there, but Lydia on the musical rounds, not probably some of the films that she was hoping for to get, but still solid with those steals and everything. And yeah, I just like Lydia was vibing throughout the whole round, and Cameron's just like very serious. So that's that's also awesome the whole time. Thoughts?
I think just a little bit, or just, you know, not getting movies that she wanted to, but still staying in 8-7. So we'll see what happens in round 3.
All right, let's see what happens. Why don't you read the rules?
All right, in round 3, both of you will get to pick 4 numbers between 1 through 12 that correspond to 4 random categories. Once you hear those categories, you can order them as your 1, 2, 3, and your 4-pointer. And there is no stealing or multiple choice. You still have 3 repeats. So any questions?
Nope.
All right, then. Cameron, you have the lead. So go ahead and give us your numbers now.
6, 9, 2, 4.
And Lydia?
Is the upper boundary 12?
12.
Okay.
Yes.
Then I'll take 1, 5, 10, 12.
Okay, since I read for Kim, I will go ahead give Lydia your categories. You picked 1. That corresponds to Worlds of DC. Five corresponds to Denis Villeneuve. 10 corresponds to video game movies. And 12. Corresponds to music/musicals.
All right, and Cameron, you pick 2, that is category of Tim Burton. You pick 4, that is category of Tom Cruise. 6 is a category of Audrey Hepburn. And 9 is a category of 2000s. Let us know if either of you needs to hear that again. If not, then feel free to not discuss it, to think it through, and yeah, and let us know what you have.
I just think it's funny that you have Cameron written as Kame.
It was too long.
Cameron.
Yeah, I was gonna write it down, Cameron, and like I stopped because it's too long. So.
I'm ready.
Ready? Okay, go ahead.
1, Audrey Hepburn. 2, 2000s. 3, Tom Cruise. 4, Tim Burton.
Okay. Sounds good.
Okay, and I'm good too.
Go ahead.
One, video game movies. Two, music musicals. Okay. Three, Denis Villeneuve. And four, Worlds of DC.
Okay. All right, so we will start with Lydia. So Matthew.
Let me, all right, so Lydia, you're a one-pointer in video game movies. Timothy Oliphant plays Agent 47 in which video game action thriller?
Oh, it's all right. I don't know. Final answer.
The correct answer is Hitman. So we'll go to your two-pointer in music / musicals. Your question is, West Side Story is set in what decade?
The 1960s, final answer.
You're so close. It was the 1950s.
Okay.
So then we'll go to your three-pointer in Denis Villeneuve. Who composed the score for Sicario?
For sure, yeah. who would have composed the score for Sicario? Repeat it for me.
Okay, using your first repeat. Who composed the score for Sicario?
Hans Zimmer, final answer.
That is unfortunately incorrect. We were looking for Johan Johansson.
Of course.
So in order to bring this back to Cameron, you will have to answer your four-pointer in Worlds of DC. Are you ready?
Yeah, for certain. This is the one.
All right. Your question is, which Netflix star plays Eugene Choi's adult superhero alter ego in Shazam? And Shazam, Fury of the Gods.
Okay. Awesome. I know Adam Brody's in it. He plays older Jack Dylan Grazer. Netflix actor. I wonder if it's the guy from How to Get Away with Murder.
Four.
Three. I don't know. Final answer. Good game, Cameron.
And your winner by way of technical knockout, Cameron Patterson. The correct answer was Ross Butler.
Oh.
13 okay, Reasons yeah. Why fame.
Why?
He was in Riverdale for like 4 seconds, too.
Yeah.
That is also.
And he got 13 Reasons Why and stayed in that show.
Yes, Kate Riverdale. Yes, Cape Riverdale. Good for him. All right, so let's put this competitor backstage and talk for a bit here, Matthew. Thoughts on the match?
Yeah, I think, you know, these two players, they are, you know, very close in knowledge. It's just unfortunately Lydia got a little bit unlucky with the movies that she got, some of those categories in round three, and so just wasn't able to bring it back today.
Yeah, and I do want to ask this question to Lydia once we bring it to her. The strategy of putting Worlds of DC at the four. Mm-hmm. I thought you would have maybe went musicals at the four, but no, the Worlds of DC threw me for a loop there. I was like, okay, interesting. Maybe she knows her Worlds of DC. But yeah, Cameron, a solid match, even with opponent's choice able to survive it. But yeah, only 1 point difference. So yeah, mm-hmm. Let's bring up the competitors here, starting with the unfortunate second place finisher, Lydia Tarr-Talcott. Lydia, unfortunately, still unable to get that first win, still going to be looking for it, but how are you feeling about your performance?
Ain't that just the way? No, I kind of knew going in. Not to say that I don't put any stock in my abilities, but I put little stock in my abilities, as I know that I'm not super knowledgeable about movies, but I did better than I thought I'd do, all things considered. So that's not bad.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough. And yeah, talking about that, round number three, what was the strategy behind the placement of those categories?
I wanted to front load.
Okay.
My easy questions, clearly, because I got them so swiftly and easily. But yeah, because I knew pretty much any category I put in 3 and 4, I was probably not going to get, regardless of how confident or how strong I was in the category. So I felt like if I put musicals at 4, like you thought, it would have been just way too niche and would have hurt my feelings as a musicals enjoyer to miss the question, even though missing a 2-pointer musicals question also really hurt my feelings. But yeah, so I was trying to like eke out whatever points I could get because I knew 3 and 4 weren't super attainable for me. But Ross Butler is actually like, that actually feels doable. I feel like I could have.
Like it might be somewhere there, but just like.
Right, I think it's somewhere there because I got Adam Brody. He's the one who sticks out in my mind from Shazam. But yeah.
No, that's fair. Matt, do you have any questions for Leah?
Well, also just like to your round two with music/musicals, I think, you know, where there are just some movies that you just aren't as familiar with. And
yeah, even in the last match when my opponents had musicals, I knew every question in musicals. So I was like, surely this can't backfire this time, but it did. Yeah. And that's
it's such a broad category. You never know. Sometimes you'll get 5 movies you love, and it's sometimes you get a bunch that you
just 5 movies you just don't know, and that's okay.
Yeah, I think, well, I don't want to speak for everyone, but I think a lot of people when they pick musicals, they're maybe expecting like, oh, stage to film adaptation kind of questions, and then every now and then there is a Marini Black Bottom type of question, like, oh yeah, I did forget that's a music movie. So yeah,
begin again, a music movie.
Movie. So yeah, and Alvin and Chipmunks, which
a music got, movie, but you got it.
Yeah, I got Alvin and the Chipmunks. Don't ever try me on Alvin and the Chipmunks.
And I'm not happening unless someone wants to write it.
If someone wants to write this, you know, we'll go ahead. Feel free. Whoever wants to write this.
Yep. But yeah, I guess then Lydia, who's next? Is there anyone next that you want to play?
I'll play anyone.
Anyone?
It's fun. I guess I don't know a lot of people still. I know a fair few, but I don't know. I'll play anybody. I think it's fun.
Okay. Fair. That sounds good. So yeah, thank you, Lydia, for today, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Thanks.
All right, and let's bring today's winner. It is the communist, Cameron Patterson. Cameron, congrats. You don't seem thrilled for the win.
I mean, come on. Let's be real here. What else was going to happen? I mean, what was going to happen happened. So that's all I need to say.
Fair. Were you shaken at all when opponent's choice landed for you?
I it was just some bullshit from the liberal countries. So I just dealt with it the way I was supposed to.
Okay, Matthew, any questions? I'm stumped.
I don't know. It doesn't seem like he has any answers.
Fair. But hey, congrats on another win on your belt, getting closer to 500 here. So who's next then? Who's next for you? Who is your on the target for you?
You, Albert.
Oh, me. Well, okay, sure. We probably need to get to 500 first. I'm way past that. So once you get to my level, then we can play. But yeah, sure.
That's what's going to happen very soon.
Okay. Well, best of luck on trying to getting to that level. But all right. So thank you, Cameron, and we'll talk to you again soon. He's a mean man. I don't like him.
He is a mean man.
All right. Final thoughts.
Yeah, he's throws out a lot of death threats. We'll see. Yeah.
We'll see if the threats that Lydia mentioned earlier on the show is going to see the light of day.
He won, so, you know, I don't think hopefully nothing happens.
That's true. Maybe we'll see. Maybe we'll see a court order or something. Who knows? With the amount of threats we've seen going around. But yeah, that is the end of today's match. Hopefully you all enjoy it. This was a fun one, and we have another one on Thursday, right?
Thursday.
Yeah. Thursday, it is Lydia's partner, Maddie Minster, who is in the chat. She will be playing Matt Fragapane, who was also in the chat. So we'll see them play out this Thursday. That should be exciting. So tune in for that one.
And we got Real Movie Feud.
Oh, when is Real Movie Feud?
That's Wednesday, I believe. But Cole is in the chat, so he can confirm it.
Gotcha. Well, tune in for that one. I think Lydia and Matt and Maddie is.
There are people on this in this match who are part of that. It is Wednesday, right?
I think it is. I think it is Wednesday. So and Cole can announce it. So yeah, that should be good. But yeah, otherwise. Thank you all for watching. Thank you to Lydia. Thank you to Cameron. Thank you to everyone watching. Thank you to Matthew. And we will see you all again next time in your next Real Trivia Entertainment video. Peace.